Tires are by far the most important component to how your car will handle. It doesn't matter how good of a setup you have. If your tires don't hook up to the surface, then your driving will suffer. Now of course, if you're racing in a spec class where everyone runs the same tire, then you won't have to worry too much about tire selection. But I don't run spec, so let's continue. One thing I must mention before we begin is that this video is going to come from the perspective of someone who does not have a tire sponsorship. There's absolutely nothing wrong with sponsorships, nor is there any foul in staying loyal to a specific brand. In fact, it can be a very wise choice. That's what you have to worry about. However, chances are if you're just starting out, you don't have a sponsor and you simply want to know what to run at what type of track. We're going to be going over three main brands of tires as they're the ones who I have the most experience with. Those brands would be Proline, J Concepts, and Schumacher, and I'll explain why Schumacher in a bit. We're also going to be focusing entirely on 10th scale two-wheel drive buggy as that's what I know best. Without further delay, let's continue. The first surface we're going to go over is a surface I see a lot of people struggle with in the States, and that's AstroTurf. Contrary to what many might tell you, there are a slight difference between AstroTurf and, say, black or gray carpet. I'd say out of the three, Turf has the least amount of grip. The number one tire manufacturer you're going to be looking at for AstroTurf is going to be Schumacher. To those of you who don't know, the most popular track surface for Europe and the UK is AstroTurf. And because Schumacher are based in the UK, they've had plenty of time to hone their tire game for AstroTurf. Pretty much any type of Schumacher tire will work on AstroTurf. Tires like Cactus and Mini Darts will work well on a hard-packed or well-used turf, whereas Mezzos, Mini Spike, and Block tires will work well for relatively new or soft turf. Block tires specifically I haven't had as much success with, but they do work well as practice tires or endurance tires, as they do last a long time. As for the front tire, you'll pretty much be wanting to run any kind of wedge or cut staggered tire. Now, if your local track doesn't carry Schumacher tires, or you simply don't want to wait the long shipping from the UK, then there's a few choices from both J Concepts and Proline that I can list off. On the Proline side, for harder, more well-used turf, you'll want Proline Prisms. For the new or softer turf, you'll want Proline Pyramids, sometimes, wedges for the front, and Hexons. On the J Concepts side, for hard turf, you'll have Twin Pins. For softer turf, you'll want to go for the Loch Ness, and Nessies are somewhere in between. I won't spend too long on gray or black carpet as I've never actually raced on either. What I will say is that the rule for hard or well-used turf applies to carpet as well. This time though, the domestic brands like J Concepts and Proline are more prevalent. Outdoor dirt is the eldest of track layouts, going back to the good old pan card days, but these days they're becoming more and more sparse. The main reason being, well... With that being said, it's still around and I doubt these type of tracks are going to go away anytime soon, so let's continue. Before we go over tire selection though, we need to go over how the track can evolve over time. To some this may be common knowledge, but bear with me. Because the track is outdoors, it's subject to, well, the outdoors. In the morning, the track might be covered in the morning dew with a loose layer on top. After that, the track might dry up and leave nothing but a loose layer. After the track has been used a bunch or is blown off, you'd be left with a hard, bumpy concrete layer underneath that, under certain light conditions, can appear blue. Each of these track conditions require a different tire choice, so let's go over them. For a loose, damp layer, J Concepts Goosebumps or Proline Blockades will work well enough. For a loose, dry layer, J Concepts Double Ds or Proline Hole Shots work pretty well, with J Concepts Flipouts being somewhere in between. In the blue groove, tires that work for dry, loose conditions will work okay for blue groove conditions, if that's all you have, but there are better options out there. And by that I mean web-style tires. Web-style tires like Proline Electrons, Positrons, and J Concepts Ellipses will work pretty well. There are some pin/block tires that work well for groove-like conditions, like the Proline Fugitives. However, personally I still use the web-style tires. At the first round of SOS at Loganville, I used a clay compound Proline Positron and it worked very well when you stayed in the groove. The most popular track layout these days in America seems to be indoor clay. Luckily, when it comes to clay, your tire choice can be very simple. Slicks like Proline Primes or J Concepts Smoothies, although I'm fairly certain the latter has been discontinued, semi-slicks like the J Concepts Octagons and Proline Inversions, and pretty much any web-style tire in the clay compound that's been worn down. And that right there is where the nuance comes from when it comes to clay tire prep. That's what ghost tread actually means. Treads that are worn, usually with a tire sander, to the point in which their treads are completely or almost completely worn down to make them act more like a slick, but not quite like a slick. Now, why would you not want to run a slick? It could be that the track is a bit on the dustier side and you need a place for the dust to go, or it could be that your track bans slicks outright. This is the only surface of the four I mentioned in this video that actually requires the use of traction compound a lot of the time, at least at the track you're seeing on screen now. Your choice of traction compound mostly boils down to how much more sticky you want your tires to act. Personally, I use this homemade compound from Black Viper. It seems to work quite well. In the end, the tires needed for each and every single track is going to differ greatly. These three tracks I've shown you are just the three I have experience with. In the end, the best way to know what kind of tire you need for your track is to look at what the fast guys are running. They tend to know what they're doing. I just wanted to give you a stepping stone to get started. That's all for now. If you liked the video, then hit the like button and subscribe if you want to see more. I'll see you later.